Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your beautiful Fast Friday, August the 26th, Daily Bread Devo. Your afternoon Devo. Today we're going to learn how to just ask. By Arthur Jackson, derived from Philippians 4:4-7. And you know what Philippians 4:4 says. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. That's what that says. I wonder if we talk about 4. I don't know. I don't see it anywhere in the passage, but wait a minute. I thought there was 150 verses in Psalm 119. And there's 150 chapters. I thought we were going to be on Psalm 119 for 3 or 4 days. How they got it 2 days and it's going to be over with. Oh well. We'll find out when we get down to that bottom. But if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Birthdays, anniversaries, prayer requests in the comment section below. And how do you just ask when you have a question? Who do you ask when you need something? When you need this thing, how do you ask? If you need help, who do you ask? If you need assistance doing something, who do you ask? If you need help with anything, just come up with an idea and say, who do you ask if you need this? Or who do you ask if you need this? If you need money, a few bucks to put some gas in your car, who are you going to ask? You just got to learn how to just ask to find out if people will loan you that money. Or if you need a vehicle, you need a ride to go somewhere, who do you ask? You ask somebody and they can't help, like, ask somebody else. Just know ahead of time who you're going to ask, and then you'll be able to judge who you're going to ask. So, but subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach a reasonable subscriber amount by the first day of fall, which is about a week and a half, 2 weeks away. So please strengthen that number up for me, or grow that number for me, and I would be much appreciated to each and every one that helps my number to grow. So I'm tired of seeing it as low as it is. I'd like to see more people join my channel. I know a lot of people don't like this, people just sitting there talking, but hey, I'm telling stories. That's all I'm doing. I know a lot of people out there like it. All the 21 people that like my Wednesday video, my morning video, I got 21 people that viewed that video. And that's what it said, 21 in 16 hours. That's amazing. It's the most views I've ever had for one video. So thank you once again. But without further ado, let's see how to just ask. Arthur Jackson, he writes, the gleeful shouts arising from our basement came from my wife, Shirley. For hours, she wrestled with a newsletter project, and she was ready to be done with it. In her anxiety and uncertainty of how to move forward, she prayed for God's help. She also reached out to Facebook friends, and soon the project was completed, which was a team effort. So while the newsletter project is a little thing in life, small and not so small things can bring about worry or anxiousness. Perhaps you're a parent walking through the stages of child rearing for the first time. A student facing newfound academic challenges, a person grieving the loss of a loved one, or someone experiencing a home, work, or ministry challenge. Sometimes we're needlessly on edge because we don't ask God for help. James 4:2. You do not have because you do not ask God, is what verse 2 says. So Paul pointed the followers of Jesus in Philippi to us and us to our first line of defense in times of need. Philippians 4:6. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. If you need help with something and nobody else can help, ask God. Hang on a minute. Hi, sorry about that. About that quick flash. Might need me to do something, so I had to. Luckily, the pause held out pretty good, so maybe been just a couple seconds for you, but it's been probably a good 10 minutes for me, so. Okay, here we go. Philippians 4:6. So when life gets complicated, we need reminders like the one from the hymn, "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what a needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. So perhaps our asking God for help, He'll lead us to ask people who can assist us. Let's see real quick. I'll be right back in a quick flash. I don't take up very much time. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. I did find that song in here. So basically that, oh, what peace we often forfeit, is the second half of the first verse, which says, what a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. Oh, because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Last verse. Are we weak and heavy laden? Cumbered with a load of care. Precious Savior, still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee. Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou will find a solace there. So, that's basically the whole "What a Friend We Have in Jesus" together. So, thinking about that, what situations challenge you that you can bring to God in prayer? And why do you hesitate to ask him or others for help? Sorry about that. Didn't get my table back far enough after my little break, the first break a while ago. So ponder those questions by saying this phrase, which is on the bottom of the screen. You might have to come back a couple hours to see it after it does go live. So, because usually I try to do 2 days in a row most of the time, and the first day is always going to be like this. Second days are automatically the phrase is there or ready to go by the time I get ready to edit and get it set up. So, but this one will be a little bit before you'll be able to see it, so come back and skip to this point to watch it. But say, Father, forgive me for not bringing my burdens to you in prayer. Help me to reach out to others and ask for help too. So your Bible reading today, we're reading Psalm 119, verses 89 through 176. So you're almost reading almost 100 verses in one. 88 we read yesterday, and then we're reading 89. I thought that was 150 verses in Psalms in 119. I guess that was total chapters of Psalms that I was thinking of, and I thought Psalm 119 had the same number. So, but I was wrong. Sorry about that. But we'll read the other half of Psalm 119, and then 1 Corinthians chapter 8. So, coming up tomorrow, we're going to be talking about episode 824, part 2, for your evening video tomorrow, which is no turning point tomorrow, which will be talking about plans and providence from Glenn Packjam. That's a new name. P-A-C-K-J-A-M. Packjam. Packjam. That's a different name than all the other ones we've been used to. So, but it's derived from James 4:13-17. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes after I get done with our turning point, tonight's turning point, and then tomorrow's morning video. And then I'll get to that one. So, but coming up at 7 o'clock, the turning point, we're going to be talking about episode 3. We're going to be talking about episode 328, and we're going to be learning about finished. 2 Timothy 4:7 is our beginning passage, which we'll be reading in the recommended reading, 2 Timothy 4:6-8. Our turning point is from Edwin Paxton Hood. E-D-W-I-N, Edwin Paxton, P-A-X-T-O-N, and Hood, like Robin Hood, H-O-O-D. But there's also a footnote from the first section from Edwin, and we'll get to that. But in our Bible reading, we're going on the next 4 chapters of Ezekiel, 9 through 12. So, stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after 7. So, I hope you enjoyed the little song, a little hymn, and you'll come back later to see what is finished. So, with that said, I love you, I appreciate you, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and he'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until later, peace out, everybody. God bless everybody. Have a great rest of your afternoon and partial evening. Come back after 7 and we will find out what is finished. Should be a good one. So until then, God bless everyone, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.